You have at least 9 months left, perhaps as much as 18.
But the first doctor gave me from 1 to 2 years.
I hope he's right. What are you going to do?
Well, I have no family. I haven't taken a day off since law school. Guess I'll try to squeeze 30 years of living into 1 or 2.
En Mark 6 y entra a la pista y lo que puede ser la última oportunidad de que el Team Mastin pueda tomar parte en la carrera. Si ustedes han estado siguiendo las pruebas de cerca, se habrán dado cuenta de que los dos primeros prototipos del Mastin no resultaron por un mal funcionamiento en la caja de velocidad. And now Monty Hughes is about to move the Mastin Mark 6 onto the track in what could be Team Mastin's final attempt at a position in the race.
How nice to see you, Lord Mel.
Who are you cheering for now that Clive owns the company?
Well, the Corettis will win again, as usual, I suppose. Clive's doing very badly.
Yeah. It's a pity.
If you've been following the qualifying, you know that Mastin's first two prototypes failed because of blown gearboxes. Now it's up to Hughes to turn the trick for Mastin and for Clive Darrow, who could certainly use a little good fortune at the moment.
Perhaps you and I could have an aperitif a little later on.
Oh, did I tell you I saw your granddaughter at Spa?
My granddaughter?
Mm. Such a sweet girl. We were in school together, you know.
And his practice time of 4 minutes, 36.3 seconds, is impressive, to say the least. The old timers say the driver has to race for a number of years before he can really expect to reach a 4:35-second target lap time. But, as you can see, young Ray Durham has ideas of his own.
Well, here we go. Keep one on ice for me.
A half a dozen, if we qualify.
Now here's the only other Mastin entry in the race. The independently owned Gaffney Bryant Mastin, Mark V. Gaffney is way back to the track for his first qualifying run of the day.
Well, I can't very well wish him ill, can I, Rudy? After all, it wouldn't be asking too much, would it, for one Mastin to finish in the money?
Gaffney might do it, sir. He's usually in the money somewhere.
I'm talking about finishing. What's happened to Hughes? You should have heard from Potrero Bend by now.
Mr. Darrell, there's a call for you, sir.
Potrero Bend?
No, sir. It's on track phone. It's first aid.
First aid?
Aye.
This is Clive Darrell. What's the matter?
How often I've asked myself that same question.
Rona!
If you look up in the stands at the back, I'll wave. Perhaps through sign language we can achieve understanding.
Rona, I'm running a race.
Well, if I'm so bothersome to you, why haven't you signed the divorce papers? You've had them for over a week.
Don't worry about your papers. You'll get them.
But it's nothing serious. For Hughes, at any rate. For Clyde Darrell, it could be very serious. Manchester's time of 4 minutes, 36.1 seconds, puts him into third starting position as of now.
And I'm sure the Garner England team, after their tough luck here last year, is more than satisfied.
Han sido eliminados por mal funcionamiento mecánico, mientras que el Gaffney Bryan Mark V, timoneado por Pete Gaffney, ha pasado la prueba para la carrera con un tiempo de 4 minutos 45.7 segundos, que pondría al Mark V en posición 27. Here is one of the ironies of the sport. A maxim of motor car racing is that a team car will almost invariably beat an independently owned car of the same make, simply because refinements are constantly being made at the factory. But today, we have seen one of the rare exceptions. All three Mastin Mark VI prototypes have been eliminated because of mechanical failures.
Poor
while
Clive.
The Gaffney Bryan Mark V, driven by Pete Gaffney today, has won a position in the race with a time of 4 minutes 45.
Relax, they'll work on it. We're still in a race.
Yeah. It's too bad they don't give away prize money just for being in the race.
Why, you say we can't finish in the money?
Judging by the way those Corettis ate me up in the straights, I'd say you'd find a better bet in a horse race. Did you see that new Mastin prototype, the Mark VI?
Yeah, I saw them tow it away.
I had that thing by 50 yards coming out of the far bend, and zap! Flashed by me like I was a spectator.
And then it blew a clutch and didn't qualify.
A clutch you can replace. I'm beginning to wish we had an engine powerful enough to burn one out.
Well, what can we lose except the race? Now, wait a minute. Now, what do you think our chances would be with a Mark VI engine?
I bet my life savings on us.
You don't have any life savings.
I bet yours.
Come on.
Where to?
We're gonna make a deal.
Judging from some of the times being recorded in practice this year, it looks as if we'll be in for one of the fastest Molinos 24-hour endurance race ever held. Last year, the Fazio won with a record-breaking lap time of 4 minutes 35.5 seconds. This year, he's already knocked off.
Congratulations.
Thanks. Clive Darrell, this is my partner, Paul Bryan.
Hello. How do you do? Sorry about the Mark VI.
Yes.
Well, it looks as if we're not going to be racing against each other after all.
I thought we might race together. Yeah, after hearing the qualifying times today, Pete and I figured we're on a ship slowly going down. Our Mastin just doesn't seem to have the power to finish in the money. Pete and I are cowards. We don't want to go down with the ship. So we think that your Six's engine in our Mastin might save us all. Put us in the money and put the Mastin company back in the winner's circle.
Mr. Bryan, if we weren't partners, I'd sue you for plagiarism. That's almost exactly the same speech I plan to make to you and Pete.
Pamper a superstitious driver?
I never pamper drivers. Now, partners, that's different. Anything you say.
Promise me the same bad luck that's been hounding the Mark VI won't make a home with us.
Don't worry. Except for the clutch, today our problems have been with the new transmission. is a little touchy. But do you plan to drive?
That's what I came here for.
Well, nothing personal, mind you, but there's such a lot at stake. I've never seen you drive. And the simple truth is, I was going to suggest Monty Hughes as second driver.
Paul's my partner, Clive. And what he lacks in experience, he makes up in blind nerve. He drives like there's no tomorrow.
Well, it was just a thought. But remember, Paul, there is a tomorrow. Tomorrow is the day you collect the prize money.
Right.
Rudy, meet Paul Ryan.
How do you do, sir?
And Pete Gaffney.
Oh, Pete and I have met before. How are you?
Fine, Rudy.
Rudy's my chief mechanic. Rudy, these gentlemen are our partners for the race. Or rather, we're their partners. We're going to transfer the Mark 6 engine to their Mastin. I think you better get both crews working on the conversion.
Yes, sir.
We're going to win this race, even if it kills us.
Everything is signed. Your divorce is now final. Well, may I come in?
I suppose so.
You know, that dog used to like me.
Well, Pudding's very sensitive to my feelings.
Well, aren't you going to offer me a drink?
I hadn't thought about it. But now that I do, I can't think of a reason why I should.
You know, Rona, people can get divorced without actually hating each other.
Oh, can they? I don't see how. That's the reason most people get divorces, isn't it?
Not necessarily. At least, I can only talk for myself.
Your actions have already spoken for you, Clive. Eloquently.
May I make one for you?
No, thank you.
What brings you to Molinos?
Racing. Have you forgotten already? I love to watch men race. Not crawl under cars and play in the grease, but actually drive them. You remember, Clive? That's how we met.
I remember.
Really, you were a marvelous driver.
It was a long time ago.
Not by the calendar, but in other ways, yes. Yes, a long time ago. Now, what brings you here?
You wanted the divorce papers signed.
No, I mean standing here drinking my whiskey and making conversation.
Rona.
No, let me tell you. You're trying to decide whether I'd really do something evil to your precious cause.
I didn't even know you knew about that.
Oh, I know. I know many, many things, but you don't, do you, Clive?
I didn't think that you could be behind anything like that.
Oh, why not? After all, look what you did to me.
Rona, we've talked about that too many times.
Well, maybe it was my pride that stopped me before. But now that I'm completely free, I want you to hear the truth. For the first and the last time. When I fell in love with you, you were a 20th century knighter, a wild man who drove wild cars and lived right on the edge of death. But then we got married and... Oh, was this wide-eyed little girl ever in for a shock. I found out you weren't a knight, but a mechanic. And a very ambitious one. You ingratiated yourself with the owner of the Mastin factory, my father, and you began seeing me as often as a maiden aunt to whom you had some dreary obligation. But it all paid off, didn't it? My father died and you got yourself a factory.
Well, if that...
As far as I'm concerned, you're one step removed from a pickpocket. Only it's down, not up. The company's on the edge of bankruptcy, isn't it, Clive?
I'm sorry you feel that way about it, Rona. Because you're wrong. About me and about yourself. I won't try to explain my motives because you're too sure of them already. But there is one thing I'd like to explain that you don't understand. You say you hate weak men. But a weak man is the only kind that you could ever live with. One who would devote himself exclusively to you.
That's not
true. The kind of man you think you'd like lives for two things, the woman he loves and his work. Sometimes he devotes too much time to his work, sometimes much too much time. In my case, I had a car on my hands that was threatened with extinction. I had to do what I could to keep it alive. And I neglected you. But I'd do it all again, Rona. All of it. Because I am what I am, and I'm not going to change for anyone. Not even the woman I love.
Oh, you're very persuasive, Clive. But then you always were.
Thank you for the drink.
Finished. Except for final adjustments and carburetion, it is, sir.
Oh. Well, then you're working on the wrong engine, aren't you?
I suppose you might say that depends.
On what?
On what I find.
You're a hard man to get an answer from, Rudy. Just what is it you're looking for?
Well, I don't like to sound like a ruddy detective, sir, but I'm looking for evidence.
Of what?
I helped design the Mark VI chassis and engine. I know this car inside out, and I know this was intentionally damaged.
Now, that's the...
I would say it was cut by a knife. See the way they mold the rear seal.
That's all I want to know.
Oh, wait a minute, old buddy. Wait a minute. Now, I want the opinion of an expert. What's this all about?
This is how the Mark VI blew its clutch.
How do you know?
Rudy.
He knew?
Well, he had a theory. Now he knows.
Uh-huh. Well, who does Rudy have a theory about that?
Rona Darrell.
Clive's wife?
His ex-wife.
That doesn't make sense. Tell me if I'm wrong, but isn't she George Maston's daughter? Doesn't she own part of the Maston company?
Well, she owns 49%. The rest was willed to Clive.
Well, 49% ain't exactly the short end.
It is to Rona. But you see, the Maston company's only a fraction of her holdings. It's all of Clive's. You get it?
Sorry, old buddy, I don't get it. How was it done?
Well, the how was easy. For a price, one of Clive's mechanics could have been had.
Maybe. What about the why?
Well, according to Rudy, that's easy if you know Rona. That's a long story. I won't bore you with a blow-by-blow description.
Bore me.
Seems Maston gave her everything she wanted, and she wanted everything. She met Clive the year he won the championship, and she wanted him.
Oh, I can think of worse fates.
Boring you too much?
I'm a captive audience. Please continue.
Well, they got married, and Clive started building autos instead of driving them. But she wanted a champion lapdog, and she got a different breed. And she felt that Clive had married her for an auto factory. The marriage fell apart. She took a trip. The next thing Clive knew, he was being divorced.
Ah, so little Rona's the perfect picture of the woman's scorn, complete with fury. That's the way Rudy sees it.
Yep. And we're in the middle.
Well, old buddy, we have a race to win. Somebody's got to do something.
I hear you volunteer.
Not exactly.
Go back to sleep.
With nightmares. Courtesy of Paul Bryan. Where are you going?
Slumming. Boyd, you qualified. Congratulations.
You too. Why don't you sit down and have a drink?
Thanks.
Wait, what do you have?
Whiskey and soda.
Whiskey and soda, dear. Paul, this is the beautiful Rona. This is the beautiful Mrs. Rona. Rona Paul.
Now, that's what I call instant introduction.
You are now the product of the 20th century living. Instant everything.
And to think it all started with mashed potatoes.
Well, I got the beautiful Mrs. Rona part. Would the last part be Daryl?
At the moment. Would it make any difference if it weren't?
What's in a name?
Great deal.
Well, would it mean a great deal to you if I told you that my...
Well, no, don't tell me. Let me guess. Since your first name's Paul, I'd say, what a wild guess, something like Brian.
Amazing. If I didn't know better, I'd think you were tipped off. Would you like another drink?
A margarita, please.
How'd you know my name?
Oh, I told you, I'm very perceptive about people. Also, I'd say you were probably from San Francisco. Of course I know who you are. The racing community is a very small one. Everybody knows everything that goes on. I'm sure, for example, you know a great deal about me.
Tell you the truth, there is one thing that wasn't in your dossier.
Oh, now what could that be?
Do you dance with suspected enemy agents?
Always. Well, how do you like working for Clive?
I wouldn't exactly say I work for him. It's more like a partnership.
There are no partnerships with Clive. You either work for him or you work against him.
Which do you do?
Oh, now you're not going to go and be dreary, are you?
Just naturally curious.
I detest sneaky men.
I'm not overly fond of petulant women.
Well, why don't you just come out and ask me if I'm doing dark and terrible things to Clive's cause?
Well, because we'd both have to face the fact that your answer would be no, wouldn't it?
Oh, I see you're another victim of Rudy's twisted imagination.
Why do you say that?
Because it's true. Isn't that a good enough reason?
Well, it's true that Rudy has his suspicions, but he's not spreading them around.
Then how do I know?
That is a good question. How do you know?
Very simple. Rudy confronted me full of righteous indignation and a sermon on the rights of men.
When did all this happen?
When the second Mark VI prototype burned out its transmission. You're a wonderful dancer, but not a very good agent. Are you a good driver?
When I'm lucky. You see, I do it for fun.
Well, you can't be very good. You haven't mentioned revs, engines, horsepower all evening. You've devoted yourself exclusively to me.
Well, I devote myself to the present. It's a habit of mine.
Are you going to kiss me?
I think so.
Have you decided?
Decided what?
Whether I'm a monster or not. A saboteur.
Matter of fact, I'd forgotten all about it.
Circumstances, I think your seeing Rona makes for a very difficult situation.
I thought you were divorced.
We are. But we have enough problems without creating new ones.
And my seeing her creates problems?
What do you think?
I think you're jumping to conclusions and landing on the wrong ones.
All right, suppose you straighten me out.
Your Mark Sixes didn't fail because of mechanical defects. They were sabotage.
You out of your mind?
You tell me after you see the rear main seal that blew your clutch yesterday.
What's it got to do with Rona?
Well, that's the reason I saw her.
You saying she's responsible?
I'm saying she might be. Now, if you think I'm wrong, tell me.
I need hardly tell you how I felt when I saw this seal. Realized that it had been tampered with. And I need hardly tell you how I feel about it now. But we've been given a new chance. A chance to prove our new engine. As you know, we were hoping to finish the carburation and fine-tune in time to make a test run before the race tomorrow. But without your help, we don't have a hope. However, under the circumstances, I feel I have no alternative. I'm placing you all on temporary suspension. And I'm asking the man guilty of this to contact me here within the next 2 hours. If the man responsible does not come forward, I'm afraid I shall have to let you all go permanently. To that man, whoever you are, I won't press charges. I promise you that. All right. I'll be waiting by the phone.
I'll get the Gaffney Bryan crew to work immediately, sir.
I'm afraid we'll never be finished in time to make a test run now.
You'll get your test tomorrow against the Corettis.
Yes, but I hate to put you in an engine you know only by name.
Yeah, well, we'll know more about it after the first lap.
I'll order some drinks.
Uh-huh.
On second thought, I'll walk.
I'll go along with you.
Sweetens the breath. A little Yorkshire, is he?
No, actually, he's a Great Dane. He drank when he was a pup. Now, let's come to the point, Mr. Weems.
Well, long and short of it is, Missus, he's fired the lot of us and put on Gaffney Bryan crew around the clock.
Well, the whole business is so stupid.
Yes, Missus.
Well, you'll just have to find someone on the new crew.
I think I can do that. There's a man I know who...
Please, I don't want to know his name and I don't want to see him. Just tell him that I don't want any of the drivers hurt.
That's all right, Missus, only...
Only you want more money.
Well, I have lost my job, and in all fairness, Missus, Mr. Darrell was a generous man. He'd promised a bonus if...
All right, Mr. Weems, you've made your point. How much do you want this time?
Say £500 now and £500 when job's done.
There's some money in my bag. Are you sure the new man can do whatever has to be done before tomorrow?
Shouldn't be a problem. You'd be surprised how easy it is.
I don't want to know the details. Just tell him that no one's to be hurt.
Will do, Missus. What did you say that little fella's name was?
Mr. Weems.
Well, I'm afraid the resemblance ends there, of course. Pleasure doing business with you, love.
This is the day of the big race.
Drivers on cars that prove themselves in the practice runs and qualified will have to prove themselves all over again in this grueling test of men and machines. We're nearing the race time now. The cars have been pushed onto the starting grid, and the drivers are lined up waiting for the starting signal. There they go! The Molinos 24-hour endurance race has begun. The lead is taken by Blanchard. Right behind him are Denning, Ancona, DeFazio, and McLeod, number 17. DeFazio has taken third position from Ancona, and coming from deep in the pack is Mark 6 prototype. That's the Gaffney Brian Mastin with the Mark 6 engine. He has gained four cars. They're coming into the railroad bend. He's lost control. He's slipping. Bursting into flame. I don't know if... Yes, here he comes. He looks all right. He's away from the car and safe. Pearson's in trouble. He's lost control. Off the track now, but he's all right. Gaffney's having major trouble. Yes, he's coming in for an unscheduled pit stop now. These are the delays that are so costly and so agonizing.
I can't get any more than 5,200 revs out of her.
They're coming into the SS now. Blanchard isn't given an inch, but DeFazio's right behind him.
It's 69 an hour ago.
Tell me more. I was there, remember?
Cool down, Pete.
You cool down.
Take it easy, will you?
All right, what could have happened?
Why don't you go and relax while we find out?
Next time, remind me to interview your wife.
Boys, cut it out.
Hey, get back in there.
Ahora,
hurry up, move.
Acelera su Master Mark 6 y entra a la pista. Lo que puede ser la última oportunidad de que el Team Master pueda tomar parte en la carrera.
Well, Rudy, what is it?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Whatever it was stopped, she's running fine.
What happened again?
Well, it was either that or going into the engine. What would you have done?
Temperamental Mark 6 engine running smoothly again. The door almost lapped by the lead cars. He's out to pick up lost time. Now beginning the fourth hour of the race. DeFazio still in the lead by 8 to 10 lengths, followed by Francona, Durham, and Van Helding. And to add to everyone's troubles, we just received a weather report that indicates we may be in for some rain. Gaffney's Mark 6 seems to be acting up again. Yes, he's coming in for a second and scheduled pit stop. Even with almost 20 hours to go, trouble like this can put a car
well,
so
he's far doing it again.
Oh, no.
Running along beautifully and then she starts missing again.
Here, check the carburetor, the faint number 3.
We've lost it.
Ah, who knows? Maybe they'll find the trouble.
I build engines to win races, not to perform miracles.
Clive, if Rudy can get her running right, she can perform miracles.
But this far behind?
We've still got time.
Well, now, what do you really think?
All I can say is I'm glad I'm not Clive.
Yeah, well, we still have 20 hours. A lot can happen.
I've got it. This is in the fuel line, a piece of steel wool.
Looks like somebody got to our crew.
Oh, it doesn't matter. We find the trouble now.
All right, boys, we're ready.
Good luck. Yeah.
Gaffney, his Mark 6 performing impressively in the last 4 hours, is pulling in for a regular pit stop and driver change. Even in this weather, Gaffney has made up the
last... She's running great, so I have to hold her back.
What for?
It's a great car. I hate to see it become a collector's item.
It's my call. I appreciate the thought, but it won't be able to spin out and lose her.
I'll see you gentlemen later.
All right.
Many minds crying is, will this be the end of the nasty Mark 9? No one is saying so, but the feeling here among the men who know the sport is that the answer will be yes. Está maniobrando contra el mito Sete de Pablo. Ahora van entrando en la vuelta del portero. A great display of skill and determination by Paul Bryant.
Call him in, what for?
Don't argue with me. Call him in.
What are you doing?
I'm going to drive.
Drive? You can't drive. You haven't driven in 3 years.
It's my problem, not his.
Bryant, a relative newcomer to the sport, has had heads turning. In less than 2 hours behind the wheel, he's wiped out the masting deficit. The pit signaling Bryant in for an unscheduled stop. Behind the Fascio, Durham and Francona is Blanchard and Denning fighting it out for fourth and Von Helding in sixth position.
Well, what's going on? We're in sixth place.
I'm taking over, Paul.
Has everyone gone crazy?
No, just climb.
It's the Fascio, Durham, Francona, Denning and Gordon. They're calling the Mark 6 back into the race. And now, into the 13th hour, the lead remains the same. Francona es tercero, Denning cuarto. Ginaral viene disparado tras Denning.
Enjoying yourself?
What are you doing here?
I've come to ask you to stop him.
Stop him? You seem to forget, Mr. Bryan, that Clive and I are no longer matched.
Sophisticated little word games. He's out there to win. And he's got to be stopped before he kills himself.
I couldn't stop him even if I wanted to.
You can try. You've got to try, because if he's hurt, if he's killed, it's your fault.
That's not true.
Yes, it's true. It's your fault because you're responsible.
What gives you the right to...
Now, you shut up. You shut up and listen to me. I was too late for cat and mouse. Did she or didn't she? The fact that you didn't plan this doesn't change the fact that it is happening. Now, right now, he's risking his neck, and the odds are getting shorter every second. Because of you. What you did. Now, I'm not here to pull a confession out of you. But right now, that man is taking risks that no man can take and live.
Darrell's coming out of Railroad Bend right on Denning's fender. He's pulling Denning's GT. But they're approaching the S's, and Darrell will be forced to... No, he's trying to come through on the outside. He'll never... He's into the S's in a slide, spinning. He's pulling her out. Fantastic. Unbelievable.
What do you want me to do?
Darrell's driving like a man possessed. I don't see how Darrell himself can keep this pace. He's back into the fifth and pressing Denning once again. Pulling in for his regular pit stop now.
Clive, you don't have to do it. You can't win now, and you don't have to. What happened was my fault.
Check number four. Quick now.
I hired a mechanic to...
The points are okay.
Oh, Clive, please.
Yeah, she's steady, she's steady.
I didn't believe it. Not for one second.
Over here, bring it over.
I can hardly believe it now.
Clive, don't. I'll lend you whatever you need to keep the company going. I didn't realize.
We're ready, Mr. Darrell.
Clive, I'm begging you. Clive, I'm begging you.
Darrell,
just entered the 15th hour. Is DiPaggio still holding the lead? Durham in second and Darrell now in third. Here he comes now, making his stride. He's coming in fast, too fast. He's losing control, spinning.
Are you all right, sir?
Yes, thank you. Have a look at the car.
All right, sir.
You sure you're all right?
Yes, positive. Thank you.
Rona! Rona!
Not too late.
As of now, we're both on probation. We'll report to each other.
The race has tightened in the last hour. Gray Durham has been slowly pulling the fascio, who's still holding the lead he captured in the first hour of the race. And here he comes, across the finishing line. Gray Durham, if he's correct, is the winner of this year's 24-hour Molinos Endurance Race.